Bryce.
Hello everyone, welcome to yet another video tutorial of WebEpic channel. In today's video, I'm going to talk about all the functionality of the filters and how it works with the feed. We'll also be showing you some examples by generating the feed to make it more understandable. As usual, we'll be using CTX feed. So without further ado, let's start the video.
So right now I'm at my WordPress website. So before going to CTX feed, I'd like to show you my products. And in the product section, you can see different types of product here. And if you look closely, you will see all these product has a different product ID. Like lady shoes has 295, bottle perfume has ID number 294, stove has 280, and etc. etc. So each product has a different product ID. We don't have to remember this ID, but this ID will play a crucial role later on this video. So I already memorized all these IDs and I'll be using this ID to search the product in the XML file. So let's go to CTX feed now, and I already created a feed named filter. So I'll be showing all the functionality of filter using this feed. So I'll be editing this filter feed and I'll go to filter section, and you'll see all these different options you can choose from. So I'll be going through each and every one of them one by one. By the way, you can already see all these options are already preset to no. You can switch it from no to yes based on your need. So the first option in the filter is remove out of stock product. What this option will do, if you switch this option from no to yes, it will automatically remove all those product which is already out of stock. So it won't appear in the feed. The second one is include hidden products. This is already preset to no, but if you switch it to yes, it will include all the product which is already hidden. So it will generate all the hidden product in the feed. The third option is remove empty description product. So it is already preset to no, but if you switch it to yes, it will basically remove all those product which doesn't have any description. So those product which doesn't have any description, it won't appear in the feed. The next option is remove empty image product. If you switch it to yes, then it will remove all those product which doesn't have any image. The last option has remove empty price product. If you switch it to yes, then it will automatically remove all those product which doesn't have any fixed price. If it doesn't have any specific amount of price, then that product won't appear in the feed. So I'll be testing all these five options by generating the XML file. So let's see what happens if you select all these five options to no. So before showing you the XML file, I'll be willing to go to my product and look if there is any product which is out of stock or not. You can see the cap is already out of stock, which has an ID number 226. So if I search with the ID number 226, which is basically cap, you can see it's showing in the XML file. The second option in the filter was include hidden product, which was preset to no. If I go to my product list and see this product named soap, you'll see this product is hidden and the soap has an ID number 273. And if I go to the feed and search with the ID number of soap 273, you'll see that soap is not showing in the XML file because it is already hidden. The third option has remove empty description product. Let's see if there is any product which doesn't have any description. If you look closely at this product named belt, you can see that belt doesn't have any description. So if you search in the XML file using the ID number of belt, which is 41, you'll see it is showing in the XML file. So belt is showing though it doesn't have any description. Next option was remove empty image product. Let's see if there is any empty image product in my product list. You can see that bottled perfume doesn't have any image and it has an ID number of 294. So if I go to the XML file and search with the ID number of bottled perfume, which was 294, you'll see it's showing in the XML file though it didn't have any picture. The fifth option had remove empty price product, which was already preset to no. So let's see if there is any empty price product on my product list or not. So if I go to my product list, you can see this lady shoe doesn't have any specific price. So if I go to my XML file and search with the product ID of lady shoe, which is 295, if I search with 295, you can see that it's showing in the XML file, though it didn't have any specific price, but it's showing in the XML file. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to my filter and I'm gonna switch all these five options from no to yes. So now if I generate my feed, all these options will work in the XML file. Like those product which is already out of stock won't show in the feed. If there is any hidden product, it will include in the feed. And if there is any product which doesn't have any description, it will remove from the feed. If there is any product which doesn't have any image, it will also remove from the feed. And last but not the least, if there is any product which doesn't have any price, it will exclude from the feed. So let's check the XML file to see the output. Remember, the product cap was out of stock. So let's search with the ID number of 226. See, it's not showing in the XML file. So the product which was out of stock is already removed from the XML file. The second one was include hidden product. I switched it from no to yes. So now if there is any hidden product in my list, it will show in the XML file. Now if you go to soap, you'll see that soap is a hidden product. So if you search with the ID number of soap, which is 273, if you search for 273, so you can see soap is showing in the XML file, though it was a hidden product. So by switching this option from no to yes, it's including all the hidden product in the XML file. The third option was remove empty description product. And we already know that Bell didn't had any description, which has an ID number 41. So let's search for product number 41. You can see there is no product with the ID number 41 in the XML file. So by switching this option, remove empty description product from no to yes, it's already removed that product which didn't had any description. The next option is remove empty image product. I switched it from no to yes. So my product bottled perfume didn't had any image, which has an ID number of 294. So if I go to the XML file and search for product number 294, you'll see it's not showing in the XML file. So it's already hided from the feed. Then there was remove empty price product. So now it should remove that product which didn't had any specific price. And that product was lady's shoe. So if I search with the ID number of lady's shoe, which is 295, let's search with 295. You'll see there is no product showing in the XML file. So it's already hidden from my feed. So that's how these five options works in the filter.